In this lecture, we're going to take a look at advanced Excel filter options. This is our sample data set. Now, in the previous video, we saw how to put a quick filter on this using the shortcut key Ctrl+Shift+L. Now, the one disadvantage of the normal filter is that if I, for example, put a filter on this, and let me also just select these two, that you don't exactly know what the filter is on until you hover your mouse over it. And then you can see that channel has been set to store and product is set to pants black, pants blue. If you want to have full control over your filter criteria, you might want to use advanced filter because there you actually put your filter criteria in separate cells so you know what they are. To do that, go to data, to advanced. Let's just take a look at the options that we have here. We can either filter the list in place, which is just like the way we've been doing so far, or we can copy the results to another location. You need to define the list range, which is normally smart enough and it picks up the correct range. Then we can define the criteria range. So this is where you are going to type in the cells. You also have the ability to extract unique records, and that's something I'll show you at the end of the lecture. But let's see how we can use this criteria range. What you need to do is to always start with the header of the criteria that you want to filter. So let's say I want to create a filter only on store here. Okay, I'm just going to unfilter this by pressing Ctrl+Shift+L. What I need to do is to put the header where store is in. So in this case, it's channel. Now you can either type it in or copy it over. It's not case sensitive. Underneath it, I'm going to type store. Now we're going to go to advanced filter. The list is fine. We're going to leave it to also filter the list in place. Now the criteria range is this one. And this includes your header because this way filter knows where to look. Okay. That automatically filters the list based on store. The great thing about this is that you can use and or conditions. You can also use wildcards here. So let's take a look at an and condition first. Let's say I want to filter for store and for pants blue. I'm going to put product because that's the header, and I'm going to put pants blue. When you put them beside one another, it means it's an and condition. So let's go back to advanced. Now we need to expand our criteria range to both of these and say okay. Okay, so that filters for store and pants blue. Now you can also say if it doesn't equal pants blue. So smaller and greater sign here and press enter. And now let's reapply the filter and we get the list of everything else that's not pants blue. Now let's take a look at the wildcards. What if we just wanted to look at everything that has the word pants in there? We can put the star sign, pants, and then star sign after. So this means that pants could also be in the middle of our label. And if we just reapply this, we get everything that has the word pants in there. Now let's say I wanted to look for store and pants or store and shirt white. Okay, so this calls for an OR condition. This means that I need to type the second criteria below this, but I also need to make sure that I have my other criterias also set. Because one criteria is store and anything with pants, or it's store and anything that has the title shirt white in there. Okay, so let's apply advanced filter again. Our range needs to be updated to this, and we say okay. Okay, so we have store and shirt white and store with anything that has pants in there. Okay, so just remember that typing in below is an OR condition, typing beside is an AND condition. Let's do something else. Let's look for sales that are greater than 200. I can expand on this. I can add in sales value should be greater than 200, okay? And also for this one, it should be greater than 200, unless I want to define something different for this combination. What does this mean now? It means it shouldn't show this, and it shouldn't show these, and that's it, right? So you should be hiding these two lines. So let's go back to advanced and let's expand our filter. Okay, so they're gone. Now let's take it one step further as well and say, don't show me anything that's above, let's do above 400. So basically the list filter should show these values that are between 200 and 400. Okay, so we can copy this here and just change this to less than 400. Okay, so let's see which ones this one should hide. This shouldn't be there, this one shouldn't be there. Okay, so let's test this and let's update this to include all of these. Okay, so that's how you can use advanced filter. You can also repeat the columns like we did here and put in different conditions in there, as long as they make sense and the and condition applies to them, like it does with numbers or with dates. What I'm going to show you last is how to copy unique records into a separate location. So for example, let's say you were interested to get the unique list of products out of the entire list. So let me just clear the filter that we have in place and let's go back to advanced filter. We're only interested in products, so I'm just going to highlight that entire column where I have products in. Now criteria range, in this case I don't need to define that because my criteria is unique records only. And let's say I want to copy it to another location, so let's copy it right here and say okay, and I get the unique list of my products. So these are the different ways that you can use advanced filter in your Excel reports. I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And for more videos like this one, don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you can get updates when new videos come out.